Okay, big story time as we talk about the Red House in North Portland. See, protesters are still there. They got the barricades spanning several blocks at this point. You're only allowed in if you have permission from the protesters. And they're trying to stop the eviction of the Kinney family from the Red House on Mississippi Avenue. I want to tell you kind of what we know so far about this as we wait really to see what happens next, which will most likely be an aggressive sweep by police. Kyla Boshi gives us a sense of things from outside the barricades.
The occupation of a blocks-long stretch of North Mississippi stretched into a third day, leaving neighbors and some businesses uneasy about what's to come.
We've never had to deal with something like this.
Christina Carey, owner of the Pilot House Distilling, fears a clash between police and activists could spill into the North Portland neighborhood. As a result, her business is closed.
You know, if, you know, gas starts getting used, I mean, that's going to go right into our business, as well as our neighbors.
Activists fortified their position at the Red House on North Mississippi and blocked the street in front of it after police tried to resecure the Red House on Tuesday. A smaller group had been camping on the property for months to support the Kinneys, a Black and Indigenous family who lived there for decades but lost their home to foreclosure. Several neighbors, who didn't want to speak publicly for fear of retribution, said they're sympathetic and support the Kinneys, but don't like the growing occupation that's blocking a public street. As the situation becomes more inflamed, it scares them.
Those present at the barricade should leave it behind, put down your weapons, and allow the neighborhood to return to peace and order.
In a video message posted on Twitter Wednesday, Portland's police chief asked the activists to leave or they'll be removed.
The Portland police will enforce the law and use force if necessary to restore order to the neighborhood.
The Multnomah County Sheriff's Office released these photos showing guns and tactical gear spotted during their brief attempt to get people to leave the Red House on Tuesday. Portland's mayor tweeted he authorized Portland police to use all lawful means to end the illegal occupation, stating there will be no autonomous zone in Portland. But as the activists strengthen their position on the street, it raises the question, what's next? We've seen similar standoffs before, like the Occupy Portland encampment in downtown Portland in 2011, the Occupy ICE protest, which carried on for weeks in 2018. In both cases, police eventually moved in to clear the demonstrations during early morning raids.
Okay, Kyla Boshi joining us now. As we kind of ponder that question about what's next, I think a lot of people are predicting what is next is going to be police moving in. What is the scene there tonight? Have you heard anything from police? Have you seen police in that area?
We haven't seen police all day. We have seen some fire trucks, which presents an interesting situation in that the street behind me is closed. So if there were an emergency situation, a fire, they would probably have a difficult time getting in there. As for businesses around here, we've seen a number of the food carts and the restaurants are open, obviously dealing with COVID challenges alone, but we have seen people coming here and doing business, etc. For many neighbors who live in the area, one of their biggest concerns is what may happen. What may happen if police come and try and clear out the area, and also how activists may respond. It's the great unknown.
Yeah, if it gets messy down there, there are a lot of people and homes and folks living in that area. So we'll keep an eye on it. Kyle, thank you for the update tonight.